Yes. Back at you. Go ahead, sir.
Anyways, I'm honored to be speaking to Al Yankovic. I really am.
No, it is I that I'm honored to be speaking to you, sir.
Oh,
this
wow.
is Mr. Excitement of South Florida.
He's like the Perry Como of talk radio.
Yes, he's lying down as he speaks.
How do you know?
We know, sir. We know all.
All your listeners are lying
down. Just get
on
with the call.
All your listeners are lying down.
Go ahead.
Turn up your radio. Turn up your radio.
Oh, yeah, I wanted to ask you, how come you're not on time delay, Rick?
We are.
You guys are simultaneous right now.
No, we're not.
Our brains run on delay.
Yes, you are. Listen. Keep talking.
Okay.
Hey.
You guys are saying.
Look at that. Wait a second. Punch us up on airtime.
Can you hear that?
He says we're not in delay.
You're not. I'm listening to myself right now.
Punch us up.
Ooh, it must have hit a cold tile.
Ooh. You mean
Hold on. I think just a second here. We're not? We're not in delay?
Oh, cool.
Well, that was a nice thing to bring out. Well, so that's the end of our call. 237 at News Talk Radio 610 WIOD. As the engineering hotline is being used by Marvin. That was it. Thank you very much, sir. And he was the guy who would have said, yeah, guess what, and then just blurted it out. So anyway, that would be a good time to listen to a song of yours.
That'd be nice.
Do you have any particular song you'd like us to feature today?
Well, you know, probably my favorite song of all time is the one that I'm currently promoting.
Let me see if I can cue it up now.
Okay.
It's called
You Don't Love Me Anymore. On 610 WIOD.
We've been together for so very long, but now things are changing. Oh, I wonder what's wrong. Seems you don't want me around. The passion is gone and the flames died down. I guess I lost a little bit of self-esteem. That time that you made it with the whole hockey team. You used to think I was nice. Now you tell all your friends that I'm the Antichrist. Oh, why did you disconnect the brakes on my car? That kind of thing is hard to ignore. Got a funny feeling. You don't love me anymore. I knew that we were having problems when you put those piranhas in my bathtub again. You're still the light of my life. Darling, I'm begging, won't you put down that knife? You know, I even think it's kinda cute the way you poison my coffee just a little each day. I still remember the way that you laugh when you push me down the elevator shaft. Oh, if you don't mind me asking, what's this poisonous cobra doing in my underwear drawer? Sometimes I get to thinking, you don't. You slam my face down on the barbecue grill. Now my scars are all healing, but my heart never will. Set my house on fire. You pulled out my chest hairs with an old pair of pliers. Oh, you think I'm ugly and you say I'm cheap. You shaved off my eyebrows while I was asleep. You drilled a hole in my head. Then you dumped me in a drainage ditch and left me for dead. Oh, you know this really isn't like you at all. You never acted this way before. Honey, something tells me you don't love me anymore. Oh, no, no. Got a funny feeling you don't love me. love me anymore.
Weird Al Yankovic, new album, Off the Deep End, cut number 11, ladies and gentlemen.
Now, look, you didn't let the whole song play through. There's 10 minutes of silence after the song, just to let it sink in.
Hey! You didn't let the song play through.
Okay, now there's 10 minutes of silence.
While everybody runs out and buys the album.
Okay, cut number 11, 4 minutes and 5 seconds.
Look, it's
by the way, Channel 7 is over here filming you now.
Hello.
And... they're the blood and gut station, Al. So they're going to have you in some kind of a traffic accident with a chalk outline on it. There you go. Okay.
That's good.
And they're starting to tell people about it. Al, they've got a happy hour just right for two.
Do they?
Yeah.
You and perhaps a loved one.
Yes.
If you had one. The Brasserie Max is just absolutely, as a matter of fact, Al has the menu. You can open that up and just weep
goal
for joy.
Goal number one, increase...
Hey, no, you don't... Dad! Give me that back. I'm going to start weeping in a minute.
Look, the spinach and three cheese dip.
That's my favorite.
Yum!
It is. It's unbelievable. And as a matter of fact, they have that as part of their happy hour appetizer menu.
Yeah, and the tomato basil cream soup. You know, nothing makes me feel better than squatting down in a bathtub full of tomato basil cream soup.
You too, huh?
Oh, yeah.
These are dishes, it says, that will knock your socks off, so you may want to just hang on to yours for the moment. They've also got oak-grilled, I was going to say onion-grilled, but these are actually oak-grilled chicken skewers. And they've got chicken on them, too. They don't just grill the skewer. Onion crisps, buffalo chicken fingers, garlicky potato crisps. We've told you time and time about the Brasserie Max and all their great food they have at the restaurant.
Man, if I ate food, I'd sure come here.
This is just the things that they're featuring for their happy hour. And they want you to know this happens to be one of, like, the best-kept secrets, but not anymore, because we're telling you about it. The Brasserie Max is located in the Plantation Fashion Mall. It's two blocks north of Broward Boulevard on University Drive between Macy's and the Sheraton at the entrance at the front of the mall.
If you're Rick and Suds Show.
Well, I know where they got the weird from. Al Yankovic is our guest this afternoon. I really wish people could have seen what you did when I said, about the accident thing. You immediately threw both legs up behind your neck.
Did I? That's part of my past now. I'm moving on with my life.
Do you exercise? Do you do this? Or are you just born gimpy?
I'm born gimpy. In fact,
that would be a title of a good song, Gimpy.
That's my autobiography, Born Gimpy.
Is it really?
I'm working on it right now.
Man, oh man, you are as limber as they get.
You probably have to run a lot. That's probably
I would imagine. Let's take a couple of calls now. We had to go away from the phones, as our nice caller pointed out. We weren't in delay anymore. And knowing you and knowing them, man, I just backed away from that real quick. Let's go to the Gables. Hello.
Hi.
Hi.
Hello,
hey.
Weird Al.
How you doing?
All right. I wanted to say I really love all your stuff. It's great.
Thanks.
And my dad was with Spike Jonze for 20 years.
Oh, who's your dad?
Freddie Morgan. He was the banjo player.
Yeah. Wow, that's great.
And I've talked to Rick and Suds.
Oh, yeah. Incessantly. We wish you'd stop.
Yeah, I know. I call every day and remind him. But I've sent stuff to Dr. Demento in L.A., too.
Uh-huh.
I like to write a lot of parodies. But, you know, I'd like to get some other callers, but I'm going to look forward to your show.
Well, I appreciate your call. Thank you.
All right, take care.
Button South tonight. What time is showtime?
I'm not sure, but if you go there right now and just wait, I'll show up eventually.
Darn right. Kendall, hello.
Buttloads.
Back at you.
How you doing, Al?
Back at you.
I'm your long-lost twin brother.
Oh, no. You're the one.
If you saw me...
You owe me money.
If you saw me, you would say, Joe, my long-lost twin brother.
I bet this guy has glasses and a mustache. Possibly even curly hair.
Possibly.
There's at least one Weird Al clone.
If you look like Al, sir, I bet you spend a lot of time alone.
Listen, when he first came out with his videos, I was living in Houston at the time, and people used to come up to me and look at me real funny and go, you.
Hey, sir, they do that to me, too, and I don't look anything like Al.
Rick, I've seen your picture. I don't blame you.
Yeah, exactly.
But seriously.
Except me, they don't go you. They usually go, ooh.
But it's twoo. But anyway, I really like your stuff. No, I'm serious. Have you ever had a Weird Al lookalike contest?
Yes, I have.
And why wasn't I invited?
Because you're a ringer, you know. We have to.
You
give
invited
you
him. It's just that lousy mail service.
You know.
You should think if you saw me out. I'm serious. Cross my heart and hope to.
We'll show up at the concert and show him.
Hello?
Yeah. You have free tickets?
Yeah.
Well, I apologize for your life.
You
I'm
are
sorry.
Exactly like Al.
If you're so good, you ought to be able to just walk on in there.
Yeah.
There you go. We'll see you there tonight, sir. Button south. Let's go to my, let's see, Miami is gone. How about Fort Lauderdale? Hello.
Hello.
This
is, am I on?
You are on, sir.
All right, I'm on. Cool. Yeah. Hey, I got a question. You guys might have screwed up a little bit.
Might have.
Well, no. In 1979, I did Wheel of Poultry.
Uh-oh.
Well.
I guess we both owe him royalties.
Yeah.
Yeah, there you go. I'll just send me the check.
In 70, early 73, we did the Wheel of Crustaceans.
That's right. Wheel of Insects?
Yeah. We just slowly worked up to meat.
Yeah. Hey,
anything else, sir?
This is a Suds and Rick show, right?
Yes, it's certainly.
That last week.
Yeah.
Okay, I got a idea for you here.
Oh, no.
A little kid show. Uh-huh. As long as you got your fat stuff left over, how about I Ate Everything About You?
That's gosh, man. I'm glad you called.
And since I just got rid of it, that'll be anonymous and could just be misconstrued into your own idea. That's very good. Okay, it's 2:53. You got to leave.
I do?
Oh. That's what they say. We want you to stay, but they say you have to go.
Oh, okay.
Oh, don't start again, crying out loud.
Where's Victoria Jackson? Now you guys. Well, you're throwing me out of your life.
Tonight at the Button South, you're also going to be on television, channel, what's its name over there?
Oh, one of those people?
Yeah, it's a single-digit station.
Who are you guys? Channel 7.
They're right next door. They don't feel like they travel a long way to see you. They're right down the hallway.
Who's next door, Al?
You could walk 25 steps and do an in-studio interview with them, so don't be thrilled.
But they came to me. That's the main
thing. Well, they did. Tonight at the Button South. Show starts at a normal time, and you don't know what it is.
At a normal time.
And I'm sure the tickets are normal. Normal. Exactly. Mm-hmm. The only thing that's not normal is...
me.
Exactly. Nice to have you here. Thank you for stopping by.
Well, thank you.
Good luck with the show.
Come on back. I will. I'll be back in about half an hour.
When you get another wheel of something. And say hi to Vicky, won't you? Well, you ruined one marriage. Yeah. And I figure you'll probably screw this one up before it's all over, too. 2:54 at News Talk Radio 610. Weeping in the background, it's been Weird Al Yankovic.
News happening in Wausau.
Now, for those who don't pay attention, like we have one lone caller who wants to talk to you, Al. And since Al is still here signing autographs, we'll just make use of the time. Weird Al has left the building, but, through the miracle of radio, go ahead, caller.
Hey, I just thought it was perfect timing. I'm sitting here looking at a copy of UHF right now on my coffee table. I went and rented it out a couple days ago, Blockbuster.
You're the one.
Is his mic on?
I'm gone. I've left the building.
Oh, okay.
Al has left the building.
Okay. So have you got to the Wheel of Fish part yet, sir?
Oh, yeah, no. I've seen it like 3 times since Sunday.
Oh, really?
It's hard to understand the first time, isn't it?
One of those subtle movies. I got to tell you, I got a 7.5-year-old son, and we just sit and roll around on the floor.
I do that all by myself.
Now, let me ask you this. Do you ever turn on the TV?
Well, no.
Okay.
But, hey, anyway, a couple other things, though, real quick. Like I said, I think the timing is just right. 2 days ago, I met, remember the first police academy, the guy who played Tackleberry?
Oh, how could I forget?
Anyway, I met him at a gas station the other day. And so to have you on the radio today.
A brush with greatness.
Wait, now I got, this is an inside Florida joke you might get or not. But I saw the perfect oxymoron the other day.
Me?
No. I saw
Didn't that stuff you use on your face? What?
With Quebec plates on it heading north.
Hey, what? I think we missed the first.
No, we got it. But your timing is wrong, sir. You got to say that around November.
Well, think about it, though.
I just did, and I said your timing is wrong. You got to do it around November. Oh, jeez, and he got upset.
Oh,
well, you know the most important thing about comedy is timing.
No, wait a second. What's the most important thing about comedy, Al? And you're not even supposed to be here. Go away now.
Okay. I'm leaving.
Go with that man. Thank you very much.
Don't have to kick around anymore. Thank you. I'm leaving.
Thank you very much for stopping by way too long. Weird Al Yankovic. Okay, we have lines open at Broward at 524-WIOD. He's going to be appearing at the Button South tonight. And basically, the reason he's still here is because he's just been inundated with autographs. I mean, during the breaks, people were running in here getting pictures taken with him, and he was running out and getting pictures taken with them. And during the song, I put on a song, man, it was like...
Busy. Victoria Jackson was right in it. He didn't even notice.
No, she just snuck in on his lap and then snuck it out. So it's 2:59 at News Talk Radio 610 WIOD. He's gone. He's left the building. People are still coming in here looking for him. We have coming up today, and we'll we'll get back to whatever we're doing. Did we actually start anything?
Yeah, that's why no, I have no, we didn't.
Okay.
Pretty proud of that.
Joe Zagacki's...
The Rick and Suds Show now presents A Moment with Ted.
So I'm eating these donuts, right?
Yeah.
And talking to Yak Meat or whatever the heck his name is. And the lady says to me, hey, are you feeling all right? I said, feel great. I think I said that already.
Yeah.
So the lady says, she feels my head, you know, like to think I'm warm. And she says, man, your eyes are all red. And I said, so? So then, John B., or whatever his name is, offers me some Visine.
Free?
I don't know. I said, man, why use that? It kills the whole thing. You know what I mean?
Yeah.
It'd be like drinking milk without...
This has been A Moment with Ted. And remember, a day without Ted is like a day without sunshine.
307 at New.
They know me, man. They told me never, ever call back again. And they're keeping my pictures. I said, send them back. No way, man. You've worn out. You're welcome here.
Just because you wanted to be butt of the run?
They said, yeah, Ted, you're it, man. You're garden and bud.
Whoa!
Yeah.
Garden and bud of a month?
Man, if you could see what I look at every morning.
Yeah. I think you can hear what you look at.
2 o'clock in the afternoon.
Every morning about 2 p.m.
Yeah. Smells like a woman in there.
This has been A Moment with Ted. And remember... A day without Ted is like a day without sunshine.